Hi. So, I'm a scientist and also entrepreneur. But like they said, I wasn't born like it. It all started when I went to a promised land of USFA. But it wasn't so promised land for me because during the first week I got fined because I left my trash in the wrong color of trash bags. But okay, that's their system. But anyway, during my work at Harvard Medical School, I had a really good mentor, and he really encouraged me during my lab work to start thinking by myself. So that when I'll come back to Slovenia, that I'll start something, a company or something. And you probably know that in the US, everybody has a company. It's the way of living there. And when I came back, as you can see, me and so I and my colleague Rock, we opened a genetic company, Diagenomy. And this was not just because of economical crisis. Like it was said previously, I adapted. So I opened the company. But it was also a reason for my first company, which by the way, we're selling sporting goods, so nothing with what I really do. But I found out that I have a passion for business, and maybe, just maybe, I have a gene for business. And, okay, I have to admit also my parents had something to do with it because you all know when a child comes home and he sits down and his mother and dad comes in and they say, well, Clement, you didn't study for 10 years to sell sporting equipment. So if you have that passion, why not try something else? So not so long ago, we just blew our first candle. That's my team. And this is now how we dress in the lab. So don't worry. And this is also the reason why I'm here today, to talk to you about genetics. It's been around me for the last 6 years. It's my passion, besides business and besides my family, of course. And everybody knows that it gave us a lot of good. So we can detect new diseases, we can treat new diseases, and so on. But a lot of people don't know that, like everything in our lives, like a coin, or like a moon that has bright side and its dark side. Also genetics has its dark side. And I'm really here to talk to you and educate you that nothing's perfect. Now, if you look at your left and if you look at your right, and I'm not saying that to see a nice lady or a nice guy at your left and right, but you can see that we're all different. And not because my clothes are different than yours, not really because our parents are different, but deep inside, DNA. This makes us unique. The four letters, that's everything. So DNA, four letters, genome, this is what you are. Not as a person, because that's something else, but as a human being. And also, technology in genetics made a huge step forward. Only in 10 years, the price or the cost of sequencing the genome dropped for 10,000 fold, from a few million US dollars to less than 10,000 US dollars now. For me as a businessman, of course, that's great, more money for me. For me as a scientist, again, we can search for new cures. But this also means that a part of the genome can be now sequenced for less than 1,000 US dollars, with a device big as this. Again, it's great. But we have to take into consideration that now this is affordable to everybody. And just picture this scenario. You go for a date with a girl, she's really nice, hot, you know, the cheerleader type. Yeah, I was in US, but I don't know that. I studied there, so.
Exactly.
But anyway, if we go back to the dating part, everything goes well. You probably know what means going for second base, so you try to kiss her. But you know, just before that, she goes, oh no, first you're gonna spit into this. And probably the reaction of a guy would be, whoa, what? And her answer would be, well, before we make out, I wanna see if we can fit together. If your genetic material is right for me, what kind of kids will we have? Now, probably don't email me because this is not reality, but we're not so far from having just a USB stick and a laptop, and you'll be able to check everybody. Now, where's ethics with this? There are some ethical issues about it, because me, that I'm an entrepreneur, the first thing that I saw is a new business model. I'm not saying that I'll go that way, but it might be. You'll go to a store, open a book, and you'll just choose what kind of kids you like. Color of hair, eyes, even choosing the right partner for you. But then at the end, where's love? We're still human beings, not robots. So, I know you'll probably say, but man, you have a genetic company. Yes, I have, and I want to educate you that there are differences between genetic companies. Some are there, sort of a pop-up genetic companies, where you get your results in a few weeks. You meet your friends, go for a coffee, and you talk about the results and just laugh. And also there's genetics that's clinically supported. And this is what I would like to say to you. You probably also like jigsaws or puzzles when you were kids. Well, I like them. I like the big ones with a few thousand pieces. Well, my parents didn't like them because everything was done in my room, sort of, not so. But also during my years of education and research, I found out that DNA, our genes, are just one part of the whole puzzle, not everything. And now we know that also our lifestyle and everything that's surrounding you can influence on you. And thinking of, now I have a mutation, now I'll get sick, it's wrong. I know a lot of cases where people did genetic tests. Also, one of our talkers today did it. And we talked about it, and he found out that he has no immunity to HIV. No. Really? Okay. He has no immunity to malaria. No way. Okay. But I could say that not even seeing him. I wouldn't need his DNA material, because I can now say that 99.999% of all of you don't have immunity to HIV and don't have immunity to malaria. And there are a lot of these cases, but one really touched me. There was a girl, I'm going to say that her name was Anne. She did this kind of test a few years ago. She found out that she has a mutation for BRCA1, which is a gene associated with breast cancer. Because she didn't have the opportunity to talk with genetic counselor, she went and removed both of her breasts. Later on, she talked with some expertise, and she found out that she has really low probability of getting breast cancer because none of her family members had it. So, at the end, what did she get? Nothing. She removed both of her breasts. We had similar experience in my own company. My colleague took a test, and when I got the results back, I found out that he has a mutation for obesity. From that point, if I would look just at that one puzzle, I would say that Rok should look like this. I know that he really likes McDonald's and so on, but anyway. But for those that know Rok, he looks like this. So, DNA is not everything. It's only a small part. And also, this is the next step, and only the first step towards cloning and gene therapy. And a few persons in history also tried that. And we need to be really careful about it. They wanted to play God. And I don't think that we're ready for it. And I also saw a movie or a commercial for European Commission a few weeks ago. And if you haven't seen it, I hope that TEDx people will show it right now. Yeah. probably just saw the girl and the women just saw the Latino guy dancing. But the girl sort of cloned herself around. And what I saw as a scientist and as a genetic freak, I saw that she was cloning herself. And also the motto at the end, the stronger we are, the more we are, the sort of, are we going that way to getting a new superior race? Do we want that? I don't think that we're ready. But people also have to know that cloning is just behind the corner. We had Dolly, and we had some new experiments. But for me, I don't want to see myself everywhere. I don't want to see my dumb face everywhere. And I certainly don't want to talk with me because I'm fed up with my crazy ideas. So, are you ready for seeing yourself at the toilet? Going for a burger? I don't think so. So, I like diversity. What I would like to say is that I really support the companies that are doing genetic testing. Why? Because they're the ones that will cure new diseases and they will get new markers for diseases. But also, I urge people to know that there are some ethical questions and nothing is always bright. It also has the dark side.